We are going to check out the new TP-Link Archer C6 or A6 today, which is a redesign of their best budget router, and coming in at just around 2500 rupees or $33. I think that this is still the best affordable router, even for people who have high speed internet connections. Hey guys, I am Siddharth and I have also reviewed most of the higher end TP-Link routers along with some even more expensive routers, so I'll also tell you why even at its price, it might be all the router that you actually need. Beginning with the unboxing, we have the power adapter with an unnecessary third pin, some papers for quick setup, a Cat5e Ethernet cable, and finally, you get to the router with antennas that are wrapped in this plastic from hell, which is really difficult to remove. The overall design of the new Archer C6 is really great. It looks quite smart with modern aesthetics and compact size, and with this knurled pyramid pattern on its top, you can also rub it against your skin if you're feeling an itch. At the back of the router, you have 1 Gigabit WAN port, 4 Gigabit LAN ports, and a reset and a WPS button that can also be used to switch Wi-Fi on or off. We of course have 5 LEDs to indicate the status of different networks, and at bottom, you can also see holes for wall mounting with plenty of ventilation. The setup is quite easy, and TP-Link has one of the best web interfaces for controlling its features while also keeping it simple, and you have plenty of options like parental control for restricting access, quality of service, you can enable guest networks, it has a firewall, WPA3 security, you have support for OpenVPN, NAT forwarding, and you can also control some of the features of the router with Alexa. You can also control most of these features with TP-Link's Tether app on your phone, and that is also quite simple to use. While the Archer C6 doesn't support a range extender mode, it does support Onemesh, so if you pair it with TP-Link's range extenders like the RE305, you can get seamless Wi-Fi coverage in a large area, and I personally use a TP-Link router with this range extender to provide a mesh Wi-Fi network to two of my flats, and it actually works quite well, and I don't have to reconnect my phone to different networks when I move between flats like before. Now this isn't a Wi-Fi 6 router, but you can still get great performance with multiple devices. This does have 2x2 MU-MIMO and beamforming, and the 5 GHz network can actually handle a lot of devices. But let's check out what kind of speeds we are actually getting. So in the best case scenario with my ROG Phone 3 very close to the router, I was able to get speeds of about 550 Mbps on the 5 GHz network, while in the room next to the router with one wall in between, I was able to get 530 Mbps. In my company office, where there are multiple walls in between, the router does take a significant hit and we get around 220 Mbps. Then coming to its 2.4 GHz performance, we are getting around 100 Mbps, which is to be expected, and it doesn't change much as we go further away with walls in between. However, because of the better range of 2.4 GHz network, I was able to get around 50 Mbps in my second flat, which means that you can use it for smart devices or casual internet browsing. The range of this router is good for a flat that is around 1200 to 1500 square feet, but for larger homes, you may consider getting a range extender if you want over 100 Mbps speeds. Give this video a thumbs up if you're enjoying, and you can also subscribe with bell because I am also getting some unreleased routers that I will cover on the channel. So in conclusion, the Archer C6 is a really great performer for the price, and you are getting basically everything that you may need. Now with more expensive routers, you will get better performance, but in most cases, the difference is only noticeable once you go beyond the speeds of 200 Mbps, and I checked what kind of internet people had, and the average result was way below 200 Mbps, so this is easily going to be more than enough. Even if you have a gigabit connection, you can get gigabit speeds on your wired devices like a PC, and you may not get 700 to 800 Mbps on your wireless devices like the Archer AX73 can provide, but even 100 to 200 Mbps is going to be enough for most kinds of streaming that you will do, so even if I had to use this router instead of my AX73, I wouldn't have been missing out on a lot. But the range of the AX73 is better, so with the Archer C6, I have to keep my range extender closer, but the difference between their range isn't that big, considering that the AX73 costs 4 times more than this. Another feature that this router is missing is a USB port, but I have never really used them in any of my routers, but if you really need that, you can go with the Archer C6U, which has a USB port. There is another model named Archer A6 that looks identical to the C6, and from my research and according to the specifications on TP-Link's official websites, these routers do indeed seem to be identical, with the difference between them only being their sales channels. I also called TP-Link support for this, and they also confirmed that both of these routers are identical. So I will have links to buy this in the video description, but before you throw your old router away, you have to realize how much of an impact the electronics you throw away can have on the environment. So I'll have some links in the description where you will find some locations where you can responsibly dispose of your e-waste. You can also check out my reviews on these higher-end TP-Link routers. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Subscribe with bell. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.